You're in the rant wormhole where I rant about whatever my $15 a month plus patrons want me to rant about. You can get one by being one. This one is for Sumo Agogo, who says, "Hi, Digibro. During your Crunchyroll Awards react video, you sang the jingle Nobody Likes You by Filthy Frank. So my rant hole request is about Filthy Frank, from any favorite videos, moments, and or influences. Also, if Papa Franku took a break from fighting Snowflake's Defenmenlists and Facebook's Booty Buddy Twitter, what the fuck are you talking about? What kind of video would it be? Rant, review, or music video would you guys make if you collaborated together? P.S. You never answered my question from the last rant. When facing comic violence, would it be more interesting for male characters to be gods of the dodge, the lord of tanks, preachers of the golden rule, or other? Thank you, DJ. I hope you have fun with this rant." Probably gods of the dodge. It's always funny to watch them, you know, someone trying to comically attack somebody, but they find some unique and creative way to dodge it. So I guess we're talking about Papa Franku. Filthy Frank, I liked him for a little while. His videos are kind of funny. I'm not really into gross out kind of shit. So, like, when it was more just, like, really gross or raunchy, like, Jackass kind of humor, like, I've never been a huge fan of that. But I love the Pink Guy music. I love all his, you know, "Shut the fuck up, you're a fucking cunt," or "Kill yourself, please, please kill yourself." I think I found out about him because of the lyric, "Bitches don't, bitches can't handle my shit. They get really upset." Oh, fuck, I can't remember how it goes. It was something that Cinemasochist said in a video that we were in together, and I think I looked it up and found out about him. But like, yeah, I like his songs, especially just the fuck you type of songs. His production is immaculate on a lot of the newer songs, like fucking "Shut the Fuck Up." That is one of the most, like, gorgeously produced beats I think I've ever heard. Also, the "Trap Dumplings," which is very clearly, like, I listened to ASAP Ferg once, and, but it's the beat is really interesting. And I love the videos for the songs, the ones where he's, like, just cooking in his room and just, like, throwing shit around in slow-mo. It looks awesome. I love the grungy aesthetic. You know, his voice is a little Mike Shinoda-y, but that's all right, you know. His lyrics are hit or miss, but a lot of them are funny. The actual comedy videos, like, I remember enjoying the Weeaboos one. I like Chin Chin, the character, but, like, a lot of it was just, like, again, it's very hit or miss. There were some videos I thought were funny, some I thought weren't. I only followed him for maybe about a year, and then just kind of lost interest. But I still go back to the songs, particularly "Kill Yourself" and "STFU." You know, when I'm feeling those kinds of feelings, you know what I'm saying? I would love to have beats like his. Like, the last time I listened to "Shut the Fuck Up," I was like obsessively trying to find a beat that sounded like it for me to rap over, and I could not find anything that was on that level, that was like trying to sound like it but actually accomplishing it. So, yeah, mad respect to the production. I don't know if he was doing it himself or if he was working with somebody, but, you know, I don't like Joji at all. Like, the music of Joji is totally boring and, uninteresting to me from what I've heard. I haven't heard the more recent shit, but, like, there's not yet been a Joji release that has achieved a level of, like, critical appreciation that would make me think I needed to go back and check it out. You know, if it's all the same as it was, then it's not something I'm interested in. But I like I eat ass as a meme. Yeah, I eat ass. I eat a lot of ass. I'm impressed with how he kept up that voice for so long when he said it was like giving him seizures. Like, there are ways to do a growled voice that won't do that to you. He didn't choose those. He was doing, like, the roughest, most difficult sounding, like, harsh on your vocal cords voice possible. I'm not surprised that he didn't want to do that anymore, that he's, you know, run off to be a musician now. And he seems like kind of an emo boy, you know? He seems like somebody who really, it's almost odd that he even put himself in the position to do the kind of videos he was doing, you know, and I'm I feel like I'm happy he escaped because it gives me hope that, like, if one day I can ever find a way to make my music take off, then I can abandon YouTube and be a musician as well. But if me and him ever worked together on something, I would want it to be a song. Absolutely. We'd have to do a rap. I would, dude, if he fucking wanted me to drop a verse on one of his fucking songs, I would be delighted to do so. I would absolutely love to spit on a Papa Franku verse, and you know I can get fucking nasty with my own lyrics. So, would I say that he was an influence? Maybe a little bit. I would say he falls in, you know, I appreciate the crazy stunts that he would do in some of his videos. Like, I remember one where he was, like, hanging out of a car, I think in Hair Cake or something. You know, like, his just rawness and willingness to offend and to, like, be out there saying and doing the crazy shit. Like, you know, I always appreciate that somebody's willing to go all out. And, yeah. That's pretty much all I can say about Papa Franku.